that they think is an all-conference USA type of performer, 1,000-yard rusher a year ago. The air attack is lethal with Jamarcus Nelson, a guy who can take the top off of a defense very fast, 199 receiving yards last week. But it's the third downs that they have to improve. They're the antithesis of what LSU experienced in their opener, 2 of 13. You cannot expect to have any level of success versus a defense as talented as LSU in this ball game without being better on third down than that.
It's 84 degrees now. It has cooled off considerably since the storms moved into the area. It's a humid night. We hope that the lightning will stay away for the rest of the night. Here goes Odell Beckham Jr. back to return. 136 kickoff return yards last week. And 254 all-purpose, tops in the SEC in week one. And Ty Long has it on the tee as UAB is going to kick it off. LSU has won 7 straight home openers. They've won 42 straight regular season games against non-conference teams. It's Saturday night in Baton Rouge and we're underway. Long into the end zone. And LSU will start at the 25. Second year starter Zach Mettenberger, 6'5", 235, the senior from Georgia. Solid first game with the new offensive coordinator.
You know, you look at his numbers, and you know, they don't really, I think, reflect how well he played in the opener. He had a couple of drops, had a couple of intentional throwaways. He looks very comfortable in what Cam Cameron and this offense is trying to accomplish, knowing that they're still going to have that strong rushing attack.
37-27 over TCU last week, one of the more impressive wins in week one in college football. First play, Mettenberger away from center, gives it to Alfred Blue. And DJ White, the middle linebacker, picks him up. But it's a gain of 5. The number is not flashy last week for Mettenberger, but Miles was very happy with his poise and the tempo at which he worked, and he was happy about the passes that he didn't complete almost more than anything.
Absolutely. You know, it's not always about what kind of pretty up box score you can put up there, but it's the decisions that you make at the quarterback position. Cam Cameron and Zach Mettenberger on the same page.
On 7-5, trying to get it to Beckham. Odell can't hang on, even though he's got those huge hands, couldn't get the completion there. It's going to bring up 3rd down and 5 for LSU.
You know, and a year ago, maybe LSU gets concerned right here. In fact, because of the, I think, lack of trust in the passing game, you know, the 3rd and 5, these 3rd and medium type of situations where they were concerned, they might even run the football. They've enjoyed a great deal of success with Mettenberger this season in this type of down and distance.
Mettenberger has plenty of time to set his feet complete. That's Trayvon Doral. 1st down out about the 43-yard line. Greg Macklin, the free safety, makes the tackle, but it's a gain of 13 as Doral, the redshirt freshman, moves the chains.
You see Mettenberger confident in the pocket. You see him working him left to right. And Trayvon Doral, I think, probably had the most important reception of the entire season. The first 3rd down versus TCU last week, and it was similar to this play where there was pressure. Mettenberger was under duress, but Doral able to corral the pass.
You see the 3rd downs last week against TCU, 8 of 14. Now Alfred Blue. And he's going to stumble and take a loss on the play of 1 as Jake Gainis, the buck outside linebacker for UAB, a converted safety, makes the stop. And we take a look at our Lee Jeans Impact matchup players. And Gainis, who just made the tackle from his linebacker spot, is in there.
You know, right on cue, a guy who, as you mentioned, beefed up a little bit. They were able to move him closer to the line of scrimmage. When they're in a 3-down look, he's the buck backer, which means he's going to be on the line of scrimmage or just off. He's going to figure prominently in their run-stopping defense.
2nd and 11 as Mettenberger checks. Terrence McGee going to get his first carry. Had a great week against TCU. He's out to the 46-yard line. McGee, a breakout game in his LSU career. 13 carries, 95 yards, and a couple of touchdowns in Arlington.
Look at Terrence McGee. We're talking with Zach Mettenberger the other day, and he talks about what a great hands he had. They moved him to receiver last year. Always a wealth of talent, seemingly, at LSU at the running back position. But he's already asserted himself as an excellent ball carrier.
It's about third and seven. Opening series for the Tigers in their home opener. Mettenberger looking right now, running to the left and up the field, and he's dropped at midfield, well short of the first down marker. Gaina steps up to make the tackle again, now fourth down.
LSU went with the same formation that they had on the previous third down. You see that bunch of receivers at the bottom of the screen. You see where 83, he's just sitting there and squatting, Traven Doral. You see the middle of the field, there's a void. Here comes McGee across the formation. Mettenberger unable to see him, though. By then, he had already decided to tuck and run. No one in this ballgame. There's no real sense of urgency on offense. Punt the football away and play field position.
After six plays, LSU's going to have to punt. Jamie Keene, third year as LSU's, replaces All-American Brad Wing. And it's out of bounds. 25-yard punt for Keene as Austin Brown, the quarterback for UAB, will bring the offense out for the Blazers. We're going to see two UAB quarterbacks tonight, Brown and Jonathan Perry. These are the numbers for Brown last season. Pretty impressive.
Well, you look at him, able to come in relief of Perry and then go the distance. He really asserted himself in the Ohio State game, throwing for 195 yards in relief of Perry and hung on to the job for basically the balance of the season. They like his arm. Make no mistake, as you see Perry there. Perry's the more mobile of the two, the more senior of the two. Brown did a good job last season for the Dragons offensively.
Always fun to watch LSU play defense. On the flat, it's complete to Jamarcus Nelson, the go-to receiver for UAB. Austin Brown threw for over 300 yards and three touchdowns last week in that overtime loss to Troy. No picks.
Yeah, he spread the ball around as well. Got Jamarcus Nelson involved. Jamari Staples, a true freshman for them as well. Number two at the receiver position. Another pass receiver in this ballgame that could figure prominently. They're going to try to challenge LSU. They have to. They're overmatched in this ballgame. They're going to take some shots.
Second and seven, Brown to Darren Reeves, the running back, turns it upfield, first down. And he is hit hard at the 39 out of bounds. That's a gain of 12 and a first down. There's the weak side linebacker, Lamine Barrow, highly respected teammate of these Tigers who wears number 18, the special number here at LSU.
And you see, well, ultimately, this Darren Reeves, excellent ball carrier, but 41 pass receptions a season ago, one of only six at the FBS level at the running back position to do that. Giovanni Bernard is a household name now in the NFL, but Darren Reeves, a lethal pass catching running back out of the backfield.
Play clock down to two. Brown gets the snap in time. Now he's going to be hit from behind by Jordan Allen. Jordan Allen, who started tonight at the defensive end spot, was all over the field last week, even though the stats didn't back it up. They love him off the edge.
Yeah, he reminds me a little bit of Sam Montgomery. You see Jordan Allen here. He's very physical versus TCU. You see him, you're leaving a back. He stays on his feet. Austin Brown, I think they motioned Darren Reeves out of the backfield. Lamine Barrow followed him all the way out wide, but Jordan Allen able to get there before Brown was able to deliver the football, a sack early in the ballgame.
There's three full-time starters back for this LSU defense. Allen, one of the newcomers. So second and 16, and the play is whistled dead. Timeout called for.
Timeout.
By UAB.
UAB, first timeout of the half.
So LSU had to punt. Now UAB's going to talk it over on their opening series. 9:30 to go here in the first quarter. Second and 16 for UAB out of their timeout. Darren Reeves, the long setback. He'll get the handoff. Runs it up to the 35 and then is driven down. It's going to be third down and long. Barrow in on the tackle again. This LSU defense, Matt, held a good TCU offense to 259 total yards last week. Now they forced UAB into a third and about 14.
You know, we talked about it maybe at the top a couple of few plays ago where we're saying UAB's going to have to take shots, but they don't want to have to take shots to get a first down. They want to have a 15-yard gain just to maintain possession.
Brown, play fake. Sets, looks to the outside, and tipped and almost intercepted. Probably should have been picked off by Dwayne Thomas, the dime back. Played just three games last year before a sports hernia, but the NCAA gave him that year back. The redshirt freshman almost had the pick.
Austin Brown, plenty of time, but you see him dialed into the right side of the passing tree. Looked to me like Dwayne Thomas is looking in the backfield the whole time. He looks like the receiver underneath the route trying to get the ball to Jamarcus Nelson. Lucky that that isn't intercepted and unlikely that anybody tackles him on the way to the end zone, taking it the other way.
So Hunter Mullins comes out to punt, standing at his own 20. Odell Beckham Jr. back at around his 22. Good punt. This sails to the 12. Beckham makes the catch. Now he's spun to the 5, and he goes out of bounds. A great punt by Hunter Mullins. 53-yard kick. With 8:34 to go in the first quarter, no score.
ESPNU. Johnny Manziel, after throwing an interception in the red zone the last time, well, he's not in the red zone here, and he's not turning the ball over here. Sabian Holmes with the touchdown. A&M up 14-7 in the second, Clay.
Matt, of course, things get real challenging for Texas A&M next week as they take on Alabama. And just moments ago, Georgia with a big win over South Carolina, ending that three-game losing skid to the Gamecocks.
Yeah, there was going to be no assistance for Georgia this season. They've lost to South Carolina 3 years in a row, somehow found a way to win the division. South Carolina's got a weaker West schedule. What's going to happen this season if they didn't take care of business?
Kenny Hilliard checks in. They gave Odell Beckham forward progress to the 11. Still a long field here for the Tigers. Beckham makes the catch. Picks up about 9. Calvin Jones, the strong safety, with the tackle.
You see Mettenberger just standing up and slinging it out there. If they're going to be off coverage, Beckham doing a good job. Known for his speed. He's also very evasive, a great return man, and that was similar to that. Just get him the football, man, let him make a play.
When you and I were talking with Les Miles and Cam Cameron yesterday, they said our best players have to touch it, and have to touch it a bunch. We just need a yard here. Second and one, it's the big fullback J.C. Copeland, the battering ram. He had a one-yard touchdown run last week. This is how the Tigers use him, short yardage and goal line.
That's a big man. I love watching LSU play with J.C. Copeland in the formation. They're seeing a lot more of it this year, incidentally. They stay in that I formation. But to watch him run downhill is a thing of beauty, really. 270 pounds slamming up into the line of scrimmage.
Got a lot of weapons. We're going to see 4 running backs today, including Jeremy Hill at some point. Les Miles said that suspension will be lifted. First and 10, Mettenberger has all day to throw deep down the middle of the field. Beckham makes the catch. He was bumped and still holding in at the 27.
We saw this last week, the play action pass. LSU willing to take a shot up top. Odell Beckham caught a big one, dropped a big one versus TCU. Here, the ball's a little bit underthrown. I mean, that's just a demonstration of how fast Beckham really is.
50-yard pass play. Now Hilliard as they go back to the ground. Odell Beckham. We talked about those huge hands. He's just a tremendous athlete.
A little bit of a double move. Just enough to get LaMarcus Farmer turned around. And you see the contact because the ball's behind just a little bit. He has to climb the ladder, almost stop his momentum to catch that ball.
He's got 2 first basemans mixed for hands.
Don't sell him short, man. Those are tennis rackets. Look at those things.
sets up a second and six, but a whistle. Penalty flags. Referee tonight is Penn Wagers.
False start. Number 65 on offense. 5-yard penalty. Now remains second.
That's the right tackle, Gerald Hawkins. He could be the most talented offensive lineman at LSU, but there are those hands we were talking about from Beckham.
Is that a wide-angle lens that they're using right there to be that close to him? When you look at it, that's got to be, what, from tip of his thumb to the end of his pinky, that's got to be, what, 10, 11 inches?
After the penalty, second and 11. Hemberger sets again to throw. Hauling it in as Beckham touchdown. Just playing catch. Mettenberger to Beckham from 29 out. Colby Delahousie. Walk-on from New Iberia, Louisiana. Didn't miss a kick last week. He's still perfect. It's 7-0 LSU.
You know, last week it was target practice versus this UAB secondary. Corey Robinson set a record for accuracy, and Zach Mettenberger, he looks pretty dialed in, finding one of his favorite targets, Odell Beckham, a playmaker, when he gets the ball in his hands. And he...
Let's go down to the third member of our team tonight, Don Davenport.
Guys, quarterback Zach Mettenberger says that his relationship with new offensive coordinator Cam Kierman is still developing. You're not going to see the two communicate a whole lot here tonight, though, especially after drives like that. Cam Kierman is up in the booth, and he said his approach, less is more. He said he got that advice from Peyton Manning when he first got into the NFL. Peyton said, as long as you prepare before the game, there's no need to communicate during the game. Clearly, that's working here tonight.
And John, the sense is around here, everybody we talk to, is that under Cameron, Mettenberger is going to become the quarterback that the fans think he can be.
Yeah, whether or not they're communicating all the time or whatever, they clearly, I think, are very fluent with one another at this point. You know, what I think one of the key takeaways from the first game was that Mettenberger was seeing the game unfold the way his offensive coordinator and play caller was seeing it. He was making the decisions the way the offensive coordinator would want him to make decisions. And so because of that, as long as you're on the same page in that regard, you see there, Mettenberger's looking up to Cam Kierman now. So clearly they're on the horn talking with one another. But so far, I think you can see that there's a rapport there, and more importantly, a trust, and not just between the quarterback and coordinator, but also with the head coach. You know, it's important that Les Miles trusts what's going on with his offense, and because of the familiarity that he has with Cam Kierman, I think that that's already established.
Kierman coaching with Les at Michigan 25 years ago. He was actually Les's groomsman, Les's wedding. So that's how close they are.
Hey, you know, if you can mix, the personal with business, why not? And especially when you're enjoying successes like they are already, but they go way, way back.
Here's James Hairston ready to kick it off. Third year as LSU's kickoff specialist. Jamarcus Nelson, 168 yards in kickoff returns last week against Troy, including a 97-yard touchdown return. This one to the five, Nelson takes it back to the middle of the field and then runs into trouble. Bottled up and driven down at the 10-yard line. And UAB will go back to work on offense. Alexander in there on the special teams tech.
Well, that's something else that they do at LSU. Your every down players. Well, Quan Alexander is going to get many snaps this year at the linebacker position. A great athlete. But you know, you think about guys like even Jarvis Landry at the receiver position. They work their ways into the every down lineups on offense or defense on special teams. Special teams is a key point of emphasis for LSU and has been a distinct advantage for them under Les Miles.
Justin Brown away from center. The play fake to Reeves off his back foot. He's going to throw that toward the sideline and on a play. Jamarie Roscoe, number 59. Now that Mingo and Montgomery are gone, he's going to be the guy off that edge for LSU as we take a look at our Lee Impact matchup.
I got a little alliteration going here. We're inspired by the J's.
You've been working on this all day.
I thought it was important. It's easier for me to remember, and I think it's going to come up in this game. Jamarcus Nelson and Jamari Staples. Staples, a big target. Nelson, the speedster, versus the two Jalens at cornerback for LSU.
Darren Reeves. Wow. A physical all-conference runner. Looks like a rag doll. There is DJ Welter. Hits him hard for no gain, and Welter is still trying to impress the coaching staff. His job at middle linebacker is hardly a sure thing right now.
Yeah, that position's in flux. You know, last year, Kevin Minter really stepped up and owned that role in the middle of the defense. And DJ Welter had some difficulties in space, making some open field tackles. They're looking for somebody to step up at that position. There, Welter able to get in the middle of traffic and make the tackle.
Tigers trying to get off here on third down. Down goes Brown. It's Roscoe with the sack.
No Mingo, no Montgomery, and it doesn't seem to be much of a problem. You see Roscoe here. He's working on Sulaco. And you see him, he just kind of mush rushes him a little bit, lulls him to sleep. Quan Alexander with the pressure on the inside. That's really what flushes Austin Brown into the pass rush of Jamarie Roscoe.
Eight defensive players taken in the NFL draft. Most programs would be crippled by that. Not at LSU. They just reload. From the end zone, it's Mullins to punt. Beckham stepping up at the 50-yard line, a fair catch. Great field position for Zach Mettenberger and the LSU Tigers. Zach Mettenberger, first home game here in 2013. Already a touchdown pass. Kevin, nothing. Let's take a look back at that last drive for LSU. Our tire rack drive recap.
I think there was an emphasis to get the ball in the playmaker's hands. Odell Beckham with a quick pass. Then a double move gets Farmer turned around. Cam Cameron likes this matchup, but Beckham had to fight for the ball in the air. And then the touchdown, he gets underneath the coverage. Mettenberger delivers it right on rhythm.
For the first time since 2006, LSU returns the top two receivers from a year ago. Beckham and Jarvis Landry, who has yet to make a catch. I'm sure we're going to see number 80 at some time real soon. Alfred Blue, they fake it to him, and around Beckham. First down to the 35-yard line. Nick Jackson makes the tackle, but it's a 15-yard play.
You see the weapon that Odell Beckham is. You see him in the return game, figure prominently, obviously, as a receiver, but also the end of rounds, a play we saw last week versus TCU that gained positive yardage.
On the pass again is Mettenberger. There was Landry. He was looking for a flag. It lands incomplete. Kelton Brackett, the corner, was there in the coverage. Jarvis Landry had a great week last week. 8 catches for 109 yards and a touchdown.
Well, Mettenberger, I think, got a little greedy here. Kelton Brackett, excellent coverage. He's underneath this route. Jarvis Landry, he's a big physical guy. He fought for balls last week for Mettenberger, but you see the pressure. Maybe didn't get quite as much on that ball as he wanted to. Probably wanted to place it outside where his receiver had more room to work.
Cam Cameron has given Zach quite a bit of leeway there on plays like that.
Yeah, he says even if he looks covered, it depends on who the player is. He's open. You see Mettenberger maybe doesn't like what he saw. But Cam Cameron giving his quarterback a lot of leash, even if it's a defender is in tight coverage. TCU did a good job last week. Many, many contested throws, but Mettenberger fitted in tight windows.
Wes Miles wants a timeout. First of the half, 7-0 Tigers. To a comfortable temperature now at Baton Rouge. 7-0 LSU here late in the first quarter. SEC news and notes. Miami with a big win for the ACC over number 12 Florida today down in Miami. Butch Jones is 2-0. And we'll talk more about Georgia South Carolina after this play. Second and 10 for the Tigers. From the UAB 35, they keep it on the ground. Gerald Brazil, didn't expect to see him this early. 10-yard run, and it was a must-have for the Bulldogs tonight.
There you see Georgia able to defeat South Carolina, to rebound from the crushing defeat in the opener versus Clemson. And yet again, Georgia likely to climb back into the top 10.
Mettenberger, the keeper, on third and short. He got the first down.
First down for the Tigers.
So that ends the losing streak against South Carolina. That was a back and forth affair all afternoon.
Georgia showing some moxie. An onside kick, stole a possession, went for it on fourth down. But regardless, South Carolina made it interesting the whole way through.
Gerald Brazil, number 24, in there. He'll take the handoff, hit in the backfield, stays on his feet. Good balance for Brazil, working his way to the outside. Calvin Jones finally tracks him down. It's going to be a pickup of about a yard. Blue, McGee, Hilliard. We think we're going to see Jeremy Hill at some point. And we've already seen that guy, Gerald Brazil.
You almost wonder, you know, are they just trying to get as many tailbacks to carry the football as possible? I mean, they're able to run it, hand it off to just about any of them and enjoy success. But Gerald Brazil getting touches unexpectedly.
Second down and 9. Mettenberger sets again to the end zone. Wide open was Beckham. Touchdown LSU. They hook up for the second time already tonight.
Mike the Tiger roaring a lot. He'll be hoarse if this pace keeps up. Odell Beckham once again. Is that Mettenberger? He was loving Jarvis Landry last week. This week, Odell Beckham doing an excellent job on the receiving end of these targeted passes. And you see Garrett McKee, he's wanting the answers. Defensive coordinator Reggie Johnson, how can we slow down this connection between Mettenberger and Beckham?
They got a hand on it, but it still got through. Colby Delahousie with the extra point. It's 14-0.
Top of your screen, Beckham is just singled up. And they have to like that matchup. He gets underneath Jimmy Jean right there. You see that. He bailing out. Beckham just hits a second gear as he gets to the goal line to get the separation.
This is the part of the LSU offense that I think excites fans here in Baton Rouge the most. That vertical passing game that has lagged really since 2008.
We were here for the opener last year versus North Texas. And this is kind of what I think everybody anticipated the passing game looking like, except nobody got it. In fact, it really took until Alabama for it to ever get on the rails. But already tonight, you can see Mettenberger delivering the football well and to receivers like an Odell Beckham. Four catches, two touchdowns. He was kept out of the end zone last week, had opportunities with some big bombs. Had one bounce off his hands, may have hurt some footsteps. But Zach Mettenberger, already you talked about it, top two receivers coming back. Landry had a big game last week, hasn't had a catch here tonight. Tried to force him to football, but Odell Beckham stepping up big already early versus UAB.
Hairston has it on the tee. Nelson, deep man for UAB. This will be a touchback. BCS Countdown, presented by Allstate, Mondays at 6 on ESPNU, also live on Watch ESPN. And the first BCS rankings don't come out till next month, but Pulse took a little hit today, as we talked about, with Florida going down, and they really struggled, especially in the red zone. Here's our stat track.
Yeah, you know, that's something that's kind of held over from a year ago. The idea that when you get down into the red zone, as you see here tonight, already LSU doing a good job offensively, racking up first downs and touchdowns.
Greg Franklin goes ahead for about three. Yep, second down. As Quentin Thomas made the tackle, let's go down to Don Davenport.
Hey guys, a couple of LSU assistants walking up and down the bench saying, you guys keep your head in the game, it's important. And then on the UAB sideline, the offensive coordinator said, we have to establish the run. That's how we have a chance. Establish the run, establish the run. You know, Darren Reeves, a back that John Chavis said is an SEC style back.
Yeah, Reeves had 110 yards rushing last week against Troy. He can put up some pretty good numbers. He's off the field right now. Franklin is in there. And it will be Franklin. Boy, he is punished behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of one. As Quan Alexander made a nice special teams play earlier, makes the hit.
He's a linebacker coming from the second level with Quan Alexander. You see him. He's lined up off the line of scrimmage, but watch him diagnose and then pierce the line of scrimmage. See that? When you find the gap and then seek and destroy on the ball carrier, tackle for loss. Quan Alexander, he's the type of linebacker that John Chavis likes. Might be a little bit undersized, but he's speedy and he's aggressive.
He likes those sleek linebackers. They're 0 for 2 on third down, and they're not going to convert here. Great pressure on Austin Brown again by that defensive front for LSU. Roscoe was there. There's Anthony Johnson, big number 90, the preseason All-American. And this defense able to get off the field again on third down.
Well, that time for Austin Brown, the pocket just collapsing all around him. You'll see Anthony Johnson, he's on the center. He just picks his side, double-teamed. Does a good job of finishing off Austin Brown. But Daniil Hunter as well, everybody just hanging around the quarterback's ankles. You can't get comfortable throwing the football like that.
Already the third time Mullins has had to punt tonight. Beckham is going to try a return. And it's a good one across midfield. He has blockers. The punter to beat, knocked out of bounds. Hunter Mullins, the punter, kept him from the end zone.
Well, Hunter Mullins, his first punt of the night was a boomer. Nice hang time. This time it was more of a line drive, and for a coverage unit standpoint, that's a killer. Not enough time to get downfield, although you see Beckham breaking tackles and then able to get to the outside. You see Craig Lawson there to escort him down the sidelines. Mullins able to get him out of bounds there at the end. As we were talking about, well, there you go. We got Odell Beckham, your starting wide receiver. You got Craig Lawson, your starting safety. He's there on the return team. He's out there to try to make a play in special teams.
61-yard return, first down, and goal to go. I don't think the clock reset. Malfunctioning play clock, we think.
We will check to see if the play clocks are malfunctioning. Please reset the game play clock. See if they will run. Turn them on. Make sure they'll run. Turn it on.
Let's do an equipment check here.
Thank
it's
you.
Working now. Yeah, that'll happen. It's the home opener here at Tiger Stadium. There'll be some bugs after 10 months.
Pin wagers like an airplane captain checking in all his gauges. Let's make sure everything's running well.
And Kenny Hilliard checking in behind big J.C. Copeland. Either one of those two could get it. Tigers struggled in the red zone last week. Here they are again. Oh, there's contact. Landry, the intended receiver. And that's going to be pass interference. Jimmy Jean going to be called for the P.I.
Gene, the junior college transfer that they're real high on, but flags appear to be on him.
Holding, number 7 on the defense. Penalty, half the distance to the goal. Automatic, first down.
Jimmy Gene, who got beat by Odell Beckham. You see him hand fighting, got a hold of the jersey with Jarvis Landry, who's going to work back towards the corner of the end zone. You see, that's where Mettenberger was going with the football, targeting Landry again. He's trying to go to him twice. Gene, that time recognizing he was out of position, rather get the penalty than give up the score.
Hilliard. Right to the doorstep. We talked about the red zone. They were not sharp last week. Three times they settled for field goals in the first half. They were better in the second half. This is their first trip in the red zone tonight, Matt.
Yeah, that, what they're looking to do, they were 100%, but they were settling for field goals, 100% scoring, 50% in touchdowns. What they want to do is always, when you get in those scoring opportunities, you want to make sure you come away with 6 points.
Last play of the first quarter, Hilliard, touchdown. Kenny Hilliard, the junior, out of Patterson, Louisiana. And it's a 3-touchdown lead now for the Bayou Bengals.
Put the big boys in there. Jonah Austin is in there. A lot of big bodies. Backup offensive tackle, just getting some extra girth. And Kenny Hilliard, he's no runt. He's one of those guys. He's got some pretty good wheels for a sizable guy, but he's basically a fullback that can run like a tailback.
They have three guys that they can use in short yardage and goal line. Copeland, Neighbors, and Hilliard. Delahoussaye out of the hold of Frugier. And it's 21-0. An impressive home opener so far for LSU, and we're just 15 minutes in. It's always fun to be in Baton Rouge on a Saturday night during football season, and the fans so far have not been disappointed. All Tigers. Nothing after the first quarter. There's Zach Mettenberger, had a couple of touchdown passes in the first 15 minutes. He is smiling.
So they're shaking hands, politicking a little bit. You know, he should be smiling. You can tell that he's much more confident. You know, we can lay it at the feet of Cam Cameron, but also we need to keep in mind, you know, Zach Mettenberger was a first-year starter.
Yeah.
You know, went to JUCO, started at Georgia, started his career at Georgia, was behind Aaron Murray, and a lot was kind of foisted onto his shoulders at the beginning of last season. I think that the tumbles are falling into place better for him this year.
Hairston puts it into the end zone, and Nelson will take a knee. Those are game trends. Rushing yards.
Wow.
You know, at average yards per play, 9.1 for LSU.
I mean, every play they run is virtually a first down, and then you look at UAB, those rushing yards, you know, Don hit on it. They're wanting to run the football. On the negative side of the ledger, Darren Reeves he's one of these running backs that's an SEC type, but he doesn't always run up against SEC type defenses.
We said we would see two UAB quarterbacks, now Jonathan Perry in, and they put it on the turf. And it looks like LSU has it. It's Quentin Thomas. He blew an opportunity like that last week in Arlington, Texas. This time, he recovers the fumble.
He didn't have a choice this time. Quentin Thomas, you know, the coaches, his teammates are saying, you got to scoop and score. This time, you see Perry in there. He just doesn't get it. All the way to Greg Franklin. Well, Perry is the more mobile of the two quarterbacks. Richard Owens, offensive coordinator, maybe trying to get something going in the run game, and instead it backfires in a big way. A bad exchange between Perry and Franklin, and Quentin Thomas this time left no doubt. He got it in the old breadbasket.
Well, we knew we would see Jeremy Hill at some point. The suspension has been lifted by Les Miles.
They play fake it to him. Mettenberger has a receiver in the flat wide open. It's Connor Neighbors, the fullback. He is hard to bring down. Goodness. 16 yards on the play. So Jeremy Hill suited up last week but did not play, last year's leading rusher. The suspension for an off-campus altercation this spring while he was on parole got him in a lot of trouble. I meant probation. So Jeremy Hill in there for LSU. Mettenberger to the end zone, man wide open, overthrow. Jarvis Landry couldn't haul it in. So this is the timeline for Jeremy Hill. Got in trouble in January, then in trouble again in April, pleaded guilty to a misdemeanor after a bar fight. Then in August, team did reinstate him. They voted him back on the team. Last week did not dress against TCU, and yesterday Les Miles said Jeremy Hill will play in this game. It's just we're going to pick a spot and this is it.
Well, I wouldn't be surprised if he actually touches the football this time. LSU substituting Jonah Austin, backup tackle.
And it is Jeremy Hill taking it in for the touchdown. And you can tell by this reaction from the fans that he's back in the good graces of the Tiger football community.
You know, Coach Miles left it to his teammates. You know, does this guy deserve to stay on the football team? And his teammates felt like he warranted another chance. And now his first carry of the 2013 season doesn't get more effective than that. One touch, one touchdown. He was in on a play action pass, was in on protection on the previous two downs. He's able to find the end zone on his first carry of the year.
28-0 LSU. Jeremy Hill, it's been a tumultuous offseason. But on this Saturday night, in the home opener, he's in the end zone.
Hill. Jeremy Hill is a guy who, you know, amongst this stable of running backs, he really stood out last season. Came on strong towards the back half. Big game versus South Carolina. But because of some of the off-the-field issues, you know, opens the door up for Terrence McGee or an Alfred Blue, who was down with injuries early in the season a year ago.
He was the leading rusher last year, set a freshman record with 12 touchdowns. And it really is an embarrassment of riches in that backfield now for LSU.
Yeah, they're drowning in talent at tailback. I mean, I think they're just messing with us. They've got defensive backs like Gerald Brazil carrying the ball. Just because they need more depth at tailback.
The cup runneth over. Harrison with that strong leg. And it's another touchback. That's the third touchback for Harrison tonight. And these are the drives for UAB tonight. Pretty fruitless.
You know, they started the game off early. Whip it out to Jamarcus Nelson. He's able to make a few guys miss. But you see punt, punt, punt. And then, you know, Jonathan Perry in there. You know, I think just trying to get something sparked offensively. Fumble the exchange to Greg Franklin. You give LSU a short field this time. They're able to capitalize on it. Something that they weren't able to do a week ago. Even when given a short field off a fumble versus TCU, 7 for a field goal. This time tonight, LSU capitalizing on all their scoring opportunities.
Austin Brown back in there at quarterback after Jonathan Perry fumbled on his only play. Brown unloads, and it's caught near the 45-yard line. That's Jamari Staples. Had a great college debut last week. 6 catches, over 100 yards and a touchdown. And here is UAB in plus territory for the first time.
Well, that was a matchup we talked about at the top. Jamari Staples versus Jalen Collins. That time got him turned around in the coverage.
Penalty flag.
False start. number 77. Offense, 5-yard penalty, remains first.
And then like that, Sulaco with the penalty. He'll take a step back here. Sulaco wet behind the ears. Garrett McGee likes him, though. Great size, 6'6", 332. I think he's going to be special. Native of Huntsville, Alabama. First and 15, it's Reeves. Trying to cut the corner on the outside. Good pursuit to the sideline. Barrow leading the charge there for LSU. This defense under the watch of John Chavis for the fifth year. The Chief, one of the most respected assistant coaches in college football. Even Garrett McGee will tell you that. He is a fan of Coach Chavis. Second and 9. Reeves on his feet for a first down to the 30-yard line.
You know, John Chavis, he's been a fixture of the SEC for years. You know, basically two decades of great work. You can see he's not pleased giving up first downs to UAB.
They go right back to Reeves. He really keeps those feet moving. Lamar Lewis, the tackle there. It's going to bring up second down and about 7.
Well, this is what Garrett McGee was wanting to get started. Get this run game going a little bit. You know, when you jump out on somebody, you get up 4 touchdowns, sometimes you can lose your edge. Defensively, LSU wants to keep their foot on the gas. That's probably what John Chavis was upset about. He wants to make sure that his defenders maintain their edge.
They pick up the pressure. Brown has to throw it away. Good pursuit. Good coverage downfield. Micah Eugene was breathing down Brown's neck. Garrett McGee was talking about his respect for Chavis, and those two were up for the Broyles Award back in 2011. Chavis won it. McGee was the offensive coordinator at Arkansas at the time, but McGee says he has learned a lot from watching Chavis coach over the years.
Well, he's just so consistent. You know, when you look at his consistency, his level of success at Tennessee, comes to LSU, and he returns the defense to prominence after a couple of years of floundering around. His units seem to always perform at a high level, consistently in the most competitive conference in the land.
Third and 7, Franklin has the first down. Helmet comes off. He'll have to leave for a play. It's an 11-yard run and a first down. That will not make John Chavis pleased.
We'll see what UAB is able to do is capture the edge. And this time, Jalen Collins, who's the fourth player, see him right here at the top of your screen. We see him, he gets sucked inside of the block. Right there, Santonio Jones able to hook him.
That's Reeves again. Is there any reason that they continue to work that side, Matt?
Well, you know, and they worked the opposite side of the formation as well. What they're saying here is that, look, we're giving up some tonnage up front. We're not exactly going to be able to go toe-to-toe with you regardless of our size. Let's try to work the edges.
Disregard the flag. There is no foul for the low block. Second down.
Pick up the flag. UAB had one first down coming into this drive. They've had 3 already on this one. Crowd getting behind this Tigers defense. They pitch it back. They're going to maybe throw. No. Darius Powell. He had the posture like he was ready to throw it downfield. He runs it ahead for 6, and now 3rd and about 4.
I think you're right, Clay. I think that's exactly what UAB was trying to accomplish. Double pass off of the pitch. Garrett McGee, I think, recognizes that they're going to have to do everything they can. They can't just be playing straight up runs, orthodox passing game. If it takes a double pass, you have to be willing to do that, especially down 4 scores on the road to a team like LSU.
Backman goes in motion. Reeves. First down to the end zone. Touchdown. touchdown, UAB. An impressive drive by the Blazers when they really needed a shot in the arm. And Garrett McGee pleased as Reeves caps the drive with an 11-yard score.
John Chavis takes a long, cool drink. I'm willing to bet he's wetting those vocal cords. Once again, you see LSU, they sink inside. And it looks to me this time Jalen Mills just takes a bad angle. And when you're the contained player on the run, you can't afford to give up your outside shoulder. Mills does that. Credit Darren Reeves, you know, forcing the play. Being able to suck up the defender, make him commit inside and then bounce it outside, showing some speed. Reeves, known to be a physical runner. He's got good lower body strength. But there on a number of runs, able to capture the edge, pick up positive yardage. Shake a pretty athletic corner in Jalen Mills to get into the end zone.
UAB goes on a 9-play, 75-yard drive in just over 3 minutes. So far, so good for the Tigers tonight. Even though UAB put together an impressive 75-yard drive just moments ago. It has cooled off nicely. It was about 95 degrees an hour before kick. Some storms moved through to cool things off. Not quite as humid anymore. Ty Long into the end zone. Odell Beckham drops to his knee. There's Zach Mettenberger. 6 for 9, 138, a couple of touchdowns.
Yeah, he seems to me to be on the screws tonight. And what he's like the most is his receiver, Odell Beckham. He's targeted him a number of times. Really, the only drop that I could think of was on a quick pass. It was a little bit low. Otherwise, Beckham finding some soft, open areas in a UAB defense. They got tenderized last week by Troy's passing offense. You can see they haven't quite recovered. Already tonight, LSU enjoying a great deal of success in the passing game.
He just joined us. Jeremy Hill has made his 2013 debut with a touchdown run. Alfred Blue in there at tailback now. Mettenberger goes to the air again, and it's complete. Caught on the near sideline. That's Deshaun Smith. Freshman tight end picks up 14. And this offense, the improvements that are expected to be made as the season goes on and what we have already seen takes some pressure off the defense, which in the last few years has had to carry the load around here.
Yeah, you know, when the passing game wouldn't work and LSU would run the football and play defense, now they actually have a threat in their passing game.
Good play fake. Dumping it off short to Copeland as Mettenberger, the big man with a first down. I remember a year ago, you said it's like steer wrestling trying to tackle this guy, J.C. Copeland, with the first down, a gain of 12.
Like a concrete truck with bad brakes. You know, he just, once he gets rolling, there's no real stopping him unless he just buries his axle into the grass. I mean, you see right there, well, nobody really wants to get in the way of this guy. You see, that punishes would-be tacklers. You think twice before you lay your helmet in there.
And now behind the other fullback, Connor Neighbors, it's Blue. Blue lost for the year with a knee injury in week 3 against Idaho last year. You can bet he is feeling good about the season that lies ahead. The senior from Butte, Louisiana. Fake to Blue. Mettenberger steps up in the pocket. Looks to the outside. Called in at the 30. There's Jarvis Landry. And that is the first catch for Landry tonight. He had 8 of those last week.
Mettenberger had Beckham streaking down the field. You don't know how hard of a throw. You talk to quarterbacks. That's an out route from the opposite hash. So you're picking up 15 yards, but the ball travels about 40 plus in the air.
Zings it to Landry again. This time he's picked up quickly and dumped. A gain of about a yard. And Mettenberger, during the offseason, worked with his wide receivers a lot in June and July. They threw hundreds of balls, and you can detect that the chemistry is starting to manifest itself.
Well, you know, I wonder if these big hands, whether or not they could take the abuse, because Mettenberger's got a strong arm. We've seen him capable of throwing off his back foot, sometimes when he shouldn't, and still have enough zip on the football to deliver it on time and accurately.
This drive started at the 25. It's McGee right up the middle. And he'll fall ahead after a 3-yard gain. Tevin Cruz makes the tackle, so third down coming up for LSU. And when Cam Cameron came in, even though Zach Mettenberger was the starter last year, nothing was in stone. Cam told Zach, you've got to win the job again.
I thought that made a lot of sense. You know, you hear about that. You want your guys to compete. You mentioned I've never seen a quarterback get better getting handed a job.
Landry. That's making your quarterback look good.
Well, Jarvis Landry, every quarterback in the country is watching this guy play. Some of the acrobatic catches he makes, he could be your best friend. Just get it in the vicinity and he can reach out and get it. Great body control on that reception, and just about all of them, a physical receiver.
And Delahoussaye, another extra point. So Jarvis Landry, what a touchdown. Jarvis Landry with a beautiful catch moments ago, the third touchdown pass for Mettenberger.
Great placement. I mean, Calvin Jones is running underneath this route. Well, Mettenberger throws it high, and you almost wonder, having seen Jarvis Landry make catches like this, I think that's exactly what Cam Cameron is talking about, where even if you see his safety over the top and you know he can come under it, throw it high and let your athlete go up there and get it at the receiver position. Last week versus TCU, did an excellent job, man coverage. And they were stuck tight to LSU receivers. Mettenberger still finding ways to get his receivers opportunities to make a play on the ball.
UAB will start at the 25. It's worth looking at again.
Look at that extension. I mean, you got a guy that's laying out. He's going to take the nesty plunge to get this score. His hands are as big as Odell's. Got to be. Yeah. A wardrobe malfunction. That's about the only thing that's malfunctioned so far for LSU here tonight.
Well, they had that punt on the first series, but since then, five touchdowns.
Lester, there is that. There's never the perfect game.
All right, UAB goes to work at the 25, down 35-7 with 8 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Austin Brown pressured. It should have been caught by Jamarcus Nelson, incomplete. Down to Don Davenport.
Guys, LSU defensive coordinator John Chavis said that tackles Anthony Johnson and Ego Ferguson are the guts of their defense. They're what they built this defense around. After that last UAB touchdown drive, you can see they're also the leaders of this defense.
No doubt about it. There's Darren Reeves on the run. Ego Ferguson, first career start last week, and all he did was become the defensive MVP of that game. There he is, number 9. And Anthony Johnson, the defensive tackle that he's paired with. What a combo.
They just find ways to apprentice the next one up on the defensive front. Anthony Johnson was a huge draft pick. A recruit.
He will be.
But he will be a great draft pick one day. Probably very soon, a junior. After last season, a number of the juniors, especially out of the front seven, making the early jump to the professional ranks.
Incomplete, fourth down. Jamari Staples, the intended receiver.
talk about the guts of a defense, your two interior defensive linemen, Ego Ferguson and Anthony Johnson. They've had Anthony Johnson double teamed several times tonight, as did TCU, and still finding a way to get contact and pressure your quarterback. He's going to draw a lot of attention all season long.
Have Ty Long do the punting this time. And LSU will have it at the 25-yard line. Here's a look at our SEC greats brought to you by Regions Bank. Tonight, Glenn Dorsey, two-time All-American defensive tackle, speaking great defensive tackles right here at LSU. 2007 SEC Defensive Player of the Year.
Not only a great player, you know, he was the guts of that defense. Well, then it was Bo Pelini's defense. But Glenn Dorsey, a leader, a captain of that football team, the heart and soul of both sides of the football, really, not just a defensive contributor.
Next up on the Regions Bank SEC Greats Tour, September 21st in Gainesville. Terrence McGee. He'll get two. You know, defensive lineman being drafted around Baton Rouge is like the Swallows returning to Capistrano. It's going to happen every year. You know exactly what to expect.
Just a matter of course, right? I mean, you see the numbers in Marcus Spears enjoying a tremendous career with the Cowboys. Glenn Dorsey was drafted by the Chiefs, the 49ers now. Barkevious Mingo, Michael Brockers was a physical presence on the inside, Tyson Jackson. Mingo's a little bit banged up, he's an undersized guy, but drafted by the Cleveland Browns in the first round.
Great protection for Mettenberger, he's able to get it to Landry. Ah, ball pops up. UAB has recovered. LaMarcus Farmer knocked it away from Landry, and UAB takes over as Greg Macklin recovers the fumble.
Jarvis Landry, we talked about the acrobatic catches. But this time, great pickup and protection by the backs. But you see Landry trying to get more yardage. The ball's in the outside arm, but what happened was Farmer was on the ground. I don't know that Landry realized while he's trying to shake Nick Jackson, I don't know that he realized that Farmer got up. Great hustle play by Farmer to get up off the ground and rake that football out.
Each team with a turnover now. Best starting field position for UAB. Nelson dumped. Micah Eugene, the nickelback. Loss of three. You know, we were talking about the defensive tackles for LSU and how John Chavis builds the defense from those guys out. And that's why he can get away with the sleeker linebackers that we were talking about. When he's got those hole fillers up front, you can have some quicker guys on the second tier.
Yeah, occupy blockers. You don't think that Anthony Johnson and Ego Ferguson are going to be singled up very much.
Off the hand of Greg Franklin, incomplete. Lorenzo Phillips in on the coverage, so now third and long here.
Well, to me, I don't know, he might have missed an opportunity up here. You'll see he's open, the receiver. You're going to be able to get an inside release. Jamari Staples, and he had him, just wasn't able to find him in the route tree.
Austin Brown unloads, man open, touchdown. The speed of Jamarcus Nelson outruns the coverage. It's a 42-yard touchdown strike.
Jalen Mills arguing that he was pushed off. You see UAB taking a turnover off of Jarvis Landry. We talked about Jamarcus Nelson. He's got great speed. Mills unable to get a hand on him as he released off the line of scrimmage. So almost unencumbered, gets into the route. It's just a go route. Austin Brown delivers a great ball.
And Ty Long with the extra point, 35-14 now with 5:19 to go before half. A turnover by LSU, the first of the night for the Tigers, turned into six. Brown to Jamarcus Nelson, and UAB has scored a couple of times here tonight in Death Valley. It's a recruiting area in Birmingham, Alabama. Yeah, they've got the big boys, Auburn and Alabama right there in their state, but they're going to get their fair share of talented players like a Jamarcus Nelson, who's from just outside of Birmingham. From the goal line, Beckham. Odell Beckham about the 21-yard line. So Zach Mettenberger and company come back out. There is Lyle Collins, Mettenberger's left tackle, the reigning SEC offensive lineman of the week. He opened that 52-yard touchdown run for McGee last week. This guy is fun to watch up front. And no offense, Matt, but I don't often say that about offensive linemen.
What are you talking about? That's the most compelling position on the field to play. Gerald Hawkins, the other right tackle, has got tremendous upside.
McGee stumbled a little bit that time.
You know, that happened last week. You know, there's a little bit of ball handling issues. There was a fumble in the backfield. And both of them involving Alfred Blue. That time, Terrence McGee, looks like he gets his feet tangled up. This offensive front, they afford this offense the flexibility of running the football proficiently, but also opening up the passing game, especially off of the play action. They have to be able to sell it and make it look like a run.
Kenny Hilliard back in the game. Nice spin. Gets out across the 25-yard line. Derek Scott there to make the tackle. This offensive line has not one senior starter on it for the first time since Nick Saban was the head coach. With that said, Les Miles, Cam Cameron, very pleased what they're seeing from this unit.
Well, and they've got guys that are young. Gerald Hawkins, the only one really with no starting experience. Trey Turner, Vidal Alexander, Lyle Collins, all forced into duty a year ago due to injuries at both tackle positions and inside. This year, Josh Williford out for the season with a concussion.
LSU trying to convert again on third down. There's Dylan Gordon, the tight end. Sophomore from River Ridge, Louisiana, making the catch. Nick Jackson brings him down just short of the first down marker. It's going to be a fourth and about a yard.
It's a great tackle by Nick Jackson. You know, Dylan Gordon didn't get the depth needed for the yardage to pick up the first at the reception.
They thought about it long and hard, but they're going to bring the punting unit out.
All right, we've seen UAB, you know, with the strip of Jarvis Landry, able to capitalize on a big pass to Nelson. And then, you know, LSU forced a punt on a possession in between, but they ran the football very effectively for their previous touchdown drive.
Flags down.
False start, number 45 on the offense. 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Second penalty against the Tigers tonight. That's Deion Jones. This is just the second punt for LSU since the game started. They punted on their first series. And Jamie Keane taking over for Brad Wing. Ironically, another native Australian doing the punting chores here in Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
How's that for recruiting? That's blanketing the globe
yes,
for talent.
Is. Nelson calls for the fair catch at the 28-yard line. 45-yard punt. 35-14 LSU on it. UAB has scored and made a stop defensively and taken some of the momentum away from LSU. It's really been the Tigers' game from the opening kick.
It has, but I'll tell you what. I know John Chavis is not very pleased with his unit. Can't be right now. One drive, scoring drive, where they were able to run the ball effectively to the perimeter. And then this next one, capitalizing on a turnover, of course, but still a big play over top of his secondary.
Brown, with more confidence now, throws it short to Jamari Staples. incomplete. So after three punts and a fumble, UAB has scored 14 points in the last two possessions. You can see how they started, and you can see what Austin Brown has done since.
Look at the